So we discovered a new way that your immune system limits inflammation. So when most of us think of inflammation, we think of that as something bad, which makes sense because inflammation, the pain and swelling that go with it, don't feel that great. But really, inflammation is a good thing. It's the start of every immune response. And so if you have an infection, like from a bacteria, you need inflammation to start that immune response so you can get rid of that infection. So we study a type of immune cell or white blood cell called a macrophage. And macrophages are really important at detecting infections like bacteria and starting inflammation. And so you can think of macrophages kind of like a smoke alarm and the infection like a fire. So when there's a fire, you want your smoke alarm to go off, make noise, and alert the fire department to come take care of that infection. And so what we discovered was one way in which macrophages figure out how loud of an alarm to call or how loud the smoke alarm goes off when they detect a fire like a certain bacteria. And so this is important because you want to call the right number of fire engines to come to your fire. If you have a fire just in your kitchen, you don't want to flood your whole house just to put out that small fire. And so in the same way, you want to make just the right amount of inflammation to deal with the type of infection that you have. So these findings were very surprising to us. We were studying a specific protein that macrophages have and that they use to actually control a different kind of smoke detector that detects different kinds of pathogens. And then we were surprised to find that actually that the same protein was being used to regulate inflammasome types of inflammation. And so it really looks like the immune response is using the same protein to control all different types of inflammation, which seems like maybe a really efficient way for your immune system to work. There are some very rare genetic diseases where you have too much inflammasome activation, too much inflammasome detection of bacteria. But there's also some relatively common diseases where the inflammasome is very important. And one of those is gout, where you have a lot of inflammation in your joints in the absence of infection, and this can cause a lot of pain and swelling. And so in these studies that we've performed, we mainly focused on responses to bacteria. But we also need to know if this type of regulation, this kind of control of inflammation, is also important in inflammatory diseases like gout that I mentioned. And so what we'd like to do is look at patient samples to see if this system isn't being used correctly when there's too much inflammation, because maybe we could target that to turn down inflammation. You could also think of this as another way. If you could turn the system up to try to turn up inflammation, maybe that could help control bacterial infection, maybe even without the use of antibiotics. So I think it's important for everyone to know that every scientific discovery, like this one, involves a large group of people. It's never just one person working by themselves. And so this discovery involved some people in my group at the Ben Arroyo Research Institute, but was also a close collaboration with a lab at the University of Washington Department of Microbiology. And we also had a lot of help in this project from scientists at the Seattle Children's Research Institute. So every big scientific discovery really always involves a large group of people working together.